Finca family to this week's episode of Finca Life, where I'm going to show you everything that's been going on this week. We've got quite an interesting episode for you. I've got quite a lot of different things happening. You're even going to see me cry, but crying with happy tears, so make sure you watch that. But I'm also going to tell you a little bit about what's happened with Toulouse, you remember our little kitten, and we'll tell you what Wayne is doing over there, and just show you what's been going on this week on Finca Life.
I'm Emma and this is Edu. We're the founders of Tenerife Horse Rescue.
We are a small non-profit, self-founded, eco-friendly animal sanctuary born in 2018. We are run by a great big family of volunteers.
And an even bigger animal family. Don't forget to press the subscribe button to follow our Finca Life adventures every week.
So we're starting in a slightly different place today, because we always end up standing in the middle to introduce around the horses, but some of the other animals need some glory as well. And here's some of our tortoises, or sunbathing, or just sunbathing. There's probably not a lot of exciting stuff happening. They've had their breakfast and now the sun's come out. It's been pretty terrible weather for the last week, so they're very happy just to be sunbathing, as are we. Although you can tell, I mean, it's not normally April and wearing black fluffy clothes because it's been really chilly. I mean, we shouldn't complain because it's still Canary Island weather, but we're not used to this. So today everyone's really happy, including the tortoises in the sun and the guinea pigs. Although the chickens are stealing the guinea pigs' breakfast. This is one of the girl paddocks of guinea pigs. And this, does anyone remember Stephanie Wonder, this little one here? She's just gone inside. We call her Stephanie Wonder. She's got no eyes, but she absolutely thrives. She does amazingly, even so. This is in the process of doing work as well at the moment. This is normally down, but we had to change some things around, and it normally stops the chickens stealing their food. But as you can see, it's not there today and they are stealing. There was about 2 years ago, somebody rang us and we had to take the birds, and we just had to quickly build something, and it survived pretty well, but we wanted to make it better and more safe. So we've had to squeeze all the birds into one side and block it all off so that we can replace this and make it a bit more secure. Now we've got a bit more time to do it. It's been like on the to-do list for about 2 years, and although it works amazingly, and it just wants to be more secure. So that's what Wayne's doing. Watch this space, and we're gonna have a much happier bird place. So all the budgies and cockatiels are squeezed in here at the moment. That's where we keep our volunteers. And then the lovebirds in separate. Despite their name being lovebirds, they're not very loving, so they have to be separate, otherwise they're mean to the other birds. But most importantly, why we're over here is Toulouse. I'm going to leave you with Adriana, because I was this was a couple of days ago now, three days ago, I think we put her in here, and I was off doing something else, and Adriana is going to tell you what's going on with Toulouse.
Hey guys, so working with animals is not only about happy things. Today we have a sad news about Toulouse. She is in quarantine for about a month already. She was very skinny when she got to us and we didn't know what is wrong with her, and recently we found out that she has a leukemia. And today we're going to transport her to her new place, where she's going to stay, hopefully, until somebody will adopt her.
Thank you.
Yeah. So this is the first moment of Toulouse in her new place. She's slowly getting to know the other cats, Marmalade and Tattoo. This is Marmalade. She already said hello. I think now she will say hello to Tattoo. Let's check. Yes, there is another cat there. I'm happy she will have some company. She spent 1 month without any other cat in the quarantine room. When we got her, she couldn't eat. She had a lot of snots inside her nose and she couldn't smell the food. Now we know it's leukemia, but before we didn't know why she's so skinny. Leukemia is strongly contagious. The other cats can get it through the blood, pee, poo, saliva. That's why we have to wash all the things she had there, all the pots, cuvettes. This is such a pity that such a young cat is suffering already from leukemia. I hope more people will be aware of this problem and will somehow protect the cats from this sickness, because it's highly contagious. That's why we have to keep our cats in the separate room. They cannot have contacts with any other animals because their immune system is very weak. I hope she will be adopted soon and she will find the family that will love her and give her all the attention she needs. Look at her now, how playful she is. Yay, she wanna play. She's just a kitty. Oh, she's sneezing a lot. She really sneezes a lot. Oh. So this is contagious, actually. This is contagious. That's why we need to clean all the room that she was before.
As you can see, hi Marmalade. As we want to make it about you, this is Marmalade. We're actually talking about Toulouse, but as you can see, she thinks that this is amazing. And after coming from the small quarantine room, although it's not the happy news we wanted where she could be free, she seems to think she's free in here and she's very happy and she gets on really well with Tattoo and Marmalade. So she's a lot of fun and we love her so much. I was going to talk about that she was up for adoption. But fingers crossed, I think that somebody is going to adopt her. I'm not going to say who or anything like this because it isn't definite yet, but fingers crossed. And if she gets, she's got a perfect home, because although she has got leukemia, she can live a long, happy life. And she's such an amazing little kitten. Isn't that right, Toulouse? Oh, she's coming. She's giving Marmalade and Tattoo a new lease of life because she's young and crazy. Young and crazy. Anyone will be super lucky to have you. See what Marmalade thinks of this. Oh, look. Tattoo, you're not going to come and join in the fun? Just sitting in the sun. Are you too cool for that, Tattoo? So we have two more things for you on this episode. I just want to say a really, really big thank you to Mr. Osso, which is an amazing website. It's a platform. It's, I think it's set in Barcelona, where they've created like an association for animal charities, people like us, to be part of it as a different way of donating and giving. They do the hard work for you. You go on their website, you pick which amazing charity, which whoever, and we're one of them. So thank you so much for them picking one of them. And then you get to pick the items that we need the most. You know, we tell them what we need, they put it on their website, and you can go directly on there. You pick it, you order it from their website, and then they hold it for us, and then we get it delivered to us because it's in Barcelona. But that's what they do. They hold it, they get it in for these charities, and they do the hard work for you. They source where to get it from. They source exactly what we need. So you know exactly that your money is going to something that charity in particular really needs. So we're really grateful and happy to be part of their website. We'll put the link below so you can have a look at it. Check out their website. And if you want to buy something, you can, for the cats or the horses. They're the things we have on there the most. So the very last thing I'm going to leave you to is a shot of us really, 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 really happy yesterday. We were very, very excited. We didn't film it all because we were just too excited. And then you get the moment when we came out of the office. We already found out the news about 10 minutes before, and we were running around the office crying and jumping excited. And then you get the moment where we told Edu and we're all outside. We came out of the office looking for all the volunteers to tell everyone the really good news. And there was no one around. We just wanted to shout it out to the world, how excited we were, and there was no one here. But I will tell you now what we're super, super excited about. Anyone who has watched our videos has heard me complain about how hard paperwork is here. People ask us what is the hardest thing about running this place, and I always answer, paperwork. It's not about raising money, although that's incredibly hard, and the sick animals, which is obviously incredibly hard, but the hardest thing is paperwork. And there's this been one piece of paper, one number, one stupid little number we've been waiting for 4 years, and we had to gamble everything to this point. Don't get me wrong, the charity's legal, everything we've done is legal, but you have to get it in so many different departments. And we needed this number, which basically says the charity, which is legal, and the animals are all legal on the same place. And we've waited this long to finally get this bit of paper, and we got it yesterday, which basically means that everything we've been working for is actually all come together, and there is no risk of losing it because of this bit of paper anymore that we needed. And it's just, there's so many things, like we wanted to have fundraising days and open days and visitors and open the yurt for rental and all this stuff, but we keep saying we can't until we have this bit of paper. And we have this bit of paper. We finally got this bit of paper, this stupid little number. It's not completely finished yet, of course, because it's never that simple here, but we are so much closer to completing it. The Spanish girls in the office have got a very busy week of finishing all the numbers and registering all the horses and this. I don't need to explain it all to you because it's a bit boring, but just be excited for us that we've waited 4 years for a number, we've got it. So enjoy us, very happy about that. So I'm going to actually just sign out from here because you can just leave on that happy note. So thank you as always for watching our video. Comment below your thoughts, ask us any questions. Thumbs up, subscribe. Remember, every time just watching our videos pays to these animals and helps us continue to rescue more. So thank you as always. See you next week. Yay!
Where is Phil?
Where is Anna?
Hello! Hello!
Do the legal dance.
Woo!
Legal dance. The legal dance. Come on.
Where is he?
That's abuse. Don't do it, please.
Hello, we have it.
We just have to pick which 5 horses we like the most. There are 15 have to leave.
Yay!
Sorry, 15 have to go. There's a stone. Where is everyone? There's not everyone.
I guess everyone's out on a ride.
Oh my god, I'm so hot.
You are.
Great.
Yeah, your job just gets harder though. No. You've got about to do some more paperwork.
Yeah,
no. This is only the beginning of your legal career.
So maybe we can get that donkey. Who was talking to the donkey person?
That's fantastic. That's so much. Yay!
It means we can do everything. We can start then working the schools, we can insure it properly, we can get the yurt legally rental. We might have to change it slightly because we've only got 5 horses, but we are in the process of doing it properly. It's much closer, yeah. It changes literally everything.
This means like,
well, now that she has to do some make it properly, but...
Because I feel like about 100 times
more to do.
Okay, so the insurance now is a critical.
I've never been more happy to work than I am right now.
So now we go to the insurance.
I'll give you a huge lift. Let's go. Should we come in?
He knows.
He goes all the time.
No celebrity.
He got so solid. He's
like a big poo.
Have you picked him up? He's well happy.
I bet you.
Chewy.
So heavy. Oh my god.
So cute. You look like the same height as me.
Hey, baby.
Oh, sorry.
Easy, your phone. Yeah, maybe we can. You might start your phone.
What can we say? Congratulations to Emma for all the hard work she's put in for the past few years, and finally it pays off. Now we are legal. That's everything we have to say. One more. Close like this. Yes. And yeah. That's a wrap, baby.